Hi everyone, here I have the figure of testes, and from here we'll see what all ducts are there which transport as well as store the sperms. So in this figure you can see the internal layer of testes is tunica albuginea, which form septas internally and create a lobules, and within each lobules there are 1 to 3 tightly coiled seminiferous tubules. So within the wall of seminiferous tubule there are Sertoli cell, and these produces fluid, so thus they pushes the sperm toward the lumen of seminiferous tubule. Then the sperm moves toward the straight tubules, these are, and from the straight tubules they enter into the rete testes. The rete is a Latin word, it means the network like arrangement. So here you can see there are the network of tubular cells. So the sperm reaches the rete testes. From here the sperm move towards the coiled efferent ducts in the epididymis, and then finally into the one common coiled tubule, that is ductus epididymis. Here it is, the ductus epididymis. So here in this 3D animation, in the lateral view you can see the structure of epididymis, and this epididymis is a comma shaped structure which lies posterior to the testes, and it has got 3 parts. The superior portion is the head, the middle narrow portion is the body, and the inferior end portion is the tail. And the tail portion is continuous with the vas deferens or the ductus deferens. Thus this structure is responsible for sperm maturation as well as their storage if they are not ejaculated. So here the ductus epididymis at the tail portion of epididymis is now continuous with the vas deferens, and it becomes straight. This ductus deferens or the vas deferens now ascend through the spermatic cord and enters into the pelvic cavity. The spermatic cord is a cord-like structure which ascends through the scrotum and enters into the inguinal canal through an inguinal ring. And the spermatic cord consists of cremaster muscle, here it is, which surrounds the testes. The vas deferens, which is continuous with the epididymis. The varied blood vessels, artery as well as the veins, the lymphatic as well as the nerve supply. Here in this animation you can see the vas deferens ascend through the spermatic cord and forms the loop over the ureter and passes posterior to the urinary bladder, here it is. So the dilated end portion of vas deferens is the ampulla, here it is, and it conveys the sperm through the peristaltic contraction and stores them for several months if ejaculation does not occurs. Then this dilated region of vas deferens as well as the seminal vesicle duct forms the ejaculatory duct, here you can see. This ejaculatory duct now drains sperm into the prostatic urethra, which lies internal to the prostate. So the sperm as well as the secretion from the seminal vesicle both drain into the ejaculatory duct and then to the prostatic urethra. Now the next duct comes the urethra, and it is about 20 cm long, and it has got 3 parts because it passes through the prostate as well as deep muscles of perineum and through the penis. So when it is passes through the prostate, it is termed as prostatic urethra, and when it passes through the deep muscles of perineum is termed as the membranous urethra, and when it is passes through the corpus spongiosum of the penis, then it is termed as spongy urethra, and it ends at the external urethral orifice. So this urethra is common passageway for the reproductive as well as the urinary system, as through which the semen as well as urine is passed to the exterior. So through this animation we have seen there are the various ducts through which sperm is transported. They become mature as well as store for several months, and these are the ducts of testes, the ducts within the epididymis, the vas deferens, the ejaculatory ducts as well as the urethra. The semen is a slight alkaline secretion which is a mixture of sperm and the seminal fluid. And in each ejaculation, there is a volume of 2.5 to 5 ml with a 50 to 150 million sperms in each ml. The seminal fluid provides sperm a transportation medium, the nourishment and the protection from the acidic environment of the male's urethra and the female's vagina. And these fluid parts contribute by the seminiferous tubule and the various accessory glands. And out of them are the paired seminal vesicles, here it is, and these are the convoluted pouch-like structure which lies posterior to the base of urinary bladder, and they secrete alkalinic fluid that neutralizes the acidic environment of the male urethra and the female reproductive tract, and this forms about 60% of total volume in the semen, and its secretion consisting of the fructose which requires for the ATP production by sperm, prostaglandin which causes the smooth muscle contraction within the female reproductive tract, as well as it helps in the sperm motility, and the clotting proteins that coagulate semen after ejaculation. The next gland is the prostate, and here it is the cross section. This is the prostate, and it lies inferior to the urinary bladder, and it's around the prostatic urethra. This one is, as the urethra crosses through the prostate, so it is known as prostatic urethra. And this gland contributes about 25% of the total volume of semen, and then it enters into the prostatic urethra through the many prostatic ducts. Its secretion is light, milky and acidic in nature. This secretion contains the citric acid, proteolytic enzymes. These then break down the clotting protein from the seminal vesicles. The next comes the bulbourethral gland or the Cooper's gland, and they are the size of about pea and located inferior to the prostate and lies on the either side of the membranous urethra. And these glands secrete alkalinic fluid into the urethra that neutralizes acid in the urine and protect the sperm, and also releases mucus at the end of penis and within the urethra. Thus, it decreases the number of sperm damaged during ejaculation. So these are the three accessory sex glands in the male: the paired seminal vesicles, then the one prostate, and the paired bulbourethral glands or the Cooper's gland. So in this video, we have discussed about the various ducts which transport the sperm from the testes toward the exterior, and the various accessory glands which contribute a fluid part which help in transportation, their nourishment, the protection and the release of semen in the female reproductive tract. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe our channel, and for more lectures you can visit our site.